This is the part of the video where we will fire the system at around 4.5 kV. We have over here a simple test setup where we have a demonstration rock connected between the two tungsten electrodes. Make sure to cover this with a thick cloth or plastic wrap so that the water doesn't splash out. We are now heading back to the main control unit. The spar gap has been adjusted to fire at around 4 kV. We will now switch on the system. Always make sure that the KV is the variac is always in zero position. Switch. Release the dump. Try the dump one more time to make sure that there is proper discharge. After this, switch on the trigger system. Make sure that the KV meter turns on for the trigger voltage. After which we will now slowly rise in KV using the variac after switching on the HV on button. The system is now charged and ready to go up in voltage. Slowly charge the system. This helps in the long life of the capacitors which are present in the main pulse power unit. Wait for the system to charge. We are going to around 4 to 4.5 kV. While we charge, this is the overlay of the entire unit. We are now at around 4 kV. When we fire, there will be a loud sound, so please be prepared for that. The KV meter will fluctuate as the capacitors are charging, hence there is some fluctuation which is completely normal. This has automatically fired at 4 kV as the spar gaps were set to that voltage. If you do not wish for an automatic fire, please charge to a lower voltage and then press the trigger button on the control panel to fire. For any further information that you would require, please contact us at the below email IDs and we would be happy to help you. Thank you.